In this video, we'll talk about fabric choices and how the fabric tool, which is found up here on your top toolbar, how that affects your embroidery designs. And so to get started with this, I'm actually going to just use the browser to go ahead and select one of these artworks and quickly convert that into embroidery. And of course, it's going to be based upon whatever the previous choice was for machine and fabric settings, whatever the defaults are. But we can choose the fabric and we can check what fabric we're currently set for right here with the fabric tool. So when I turn that on, you can see that the embroidery currently is set for the embroidery category smooth with the fabric type of denim. And the primary color and the secondary color were set at kind of purple and yellow, so it makes the denim look like this. And basically, what's really going to affect the way that the machine stitches is your embroidery category. So, for example, if you choose smooth versus ultralight, light, normal, normal light, and heavy. So we'll start with smooth and the denim and say, okay, now the way that you can see how your embroidery design will actually stitch out is to use the slow redraw tool. And when I turn on slow redraw, and I could press play and watch the little bulldog stitch out, but it's gonna go at 600 stitches per minute or whatever speed I type in. But if I want to, I can just pause that, and that allows me to grab the current stitch position right here, and I can just quickly drag it. And so you can see as I do this, the type of sort of underlay and the sequence of the stitching and what it kind of looks like and the way the design is going to stitch out. So the reason I bring that up now is because all of the choices the software made about the type of stitch and the type of underlay and the type of density and all the basic properties for these segments have been generated based on the fabric. And if I click on fabric, so let's just turn off the slow redraw tool for a minute and go back to fabric and change it from smooth to, let's say, ultra light, you know, and imagine sewing this bulldog on something very light like bridal tool, which maybe it's too much to ask, but you'll see what the software can do. So I'll say okay. Now the software thinks we're trying to sew this design on something very light and open, and if I choose slow redraw, and then notice now if I just drag that playhead again, there's very little, if any, underlay stitches. And you can see that the stitching has been opened up to be, I guess, less density. You know, and it's certainly going to be way less stitches. Like, can you see how that red looks more open and sparse? And so that's the software using the fabric choice to change the way that the final stitching is going to be. And so that is really the purpose of having a fabric choice. Is a very important part of the software and how it will change the results of the stitches that get created. So again, you select on the fabric tool, you choose your category. So this time we can choose normal, and then you can choose to have this will, for display on your screen, allows you to replicate exactly what you're stitching on. So if it's, you know, a flannel or fleece or whatever you have, you choose it, you can choose the color that it's going to be, set the color of that fabric, and that, and then when you say okay, that becomes your background. Now why did I not get that color? Embroidery category is normal. And say, okay, oh, because I'm still in the slow redraw mode. And so it just didn't catch up with me until I turned that slow redraw mode off. But the point is, you can change the fabric in your designs, and then that will in turn change the results of the embroidery stitches.